Hi, let's talk about the larynx and the laryngoskeleton. In this video, we'll discuss the larynx, where it's located, and its functions. We'll also discuss the laryngoskeleton and its constituent cartilages and their features. So the larynx, colloquially known as the voice box, sits inferior to the hyoid bone. It's actually suspended from the hyoid bone by the thyrohyoid membrane, which attaches to the thyroid cartilage of the larynx. It's superior to the trachea, and it helps to suspend the trachea by the cricotracheal ligament. And it's sitting anterior to the laryngopharynx, which would be approximately here. This is in line with the cervical vertebral levels of approximately C4 through C6, but in some individuals the larynx may be elevated and in others it may be depressed. So the larynx consists of a laryngoskeleton as well as intrinsic membranes and connective tissues, as well as various intrinsic muscles. And so let's outline some of those elements of the laryngoskeleton, or the cartilaginous framework of the larynx. So there are going to be three major unpaired cartilaginous elements. These include the thyroid cartilage, the epiglottic cartilage, and the cricoid cartilage. The remaining cartilages are all bilaterally paired. So sitting atop the posterior aspect of the cricoid cartilage are the arytenoid cartilages. These are sort of funnel shaped. And atop the arytenoid cartilages are the corniculate cartilages. And then between the arytenoid cartilages and the epiglottis are these airy epiglottic folds, and within those folds are the cuneiform cartilages. And there may be other smaller cartilages that more typically or less typically appear throughout the larynx, but these are the major elements of the laryngoskeleton. These cartilaginous elements are hyaline cartilage, and as an individual ages, starting at about 18 years of age, they begin the process of calcification. So let's take a look at some of the features of the laryngoskeleton. Let me just outline for you here. This is the thyroid cartilage. The thyroid cartilage consists of two laminae that come together along the midline. That midline can sometimes be very robust, especially in individuals with a lot of testosterone, because testosterone builds muscle mass and muscle pulls on various features of the skeletal system and cartilage to exacerbate them. And so that's the laryngeal prominence, aka Adam's apple. Looking posteriorly, there are going to be two sets of horns, a superior horn. The superior horn is in line with the greater horn of the hyoid bone. So these two are going to articulate with an intermediate thyrohyoid membrane. So there's the thyrohyoid membrane. And then that inferior horn is going to form a joint with the cricoid cartilage there. So that's the cricothyroid joint. Upon which the cricothyroid muscles, which are intrinsic muscles of the larynx, can work. And so when these muscles fire, the thyroid cartilage tips anteriorly and inferiorly. And that's going to put tension on vocal folds to increase pitch. The cricoid cartilage, cricoid comes from cricios, which means a ring, is the only cartilage to completely surround the airway within the larynx. So it is 360 degrees complete. Posteriorly upon the cricoid cartilage are where the arytenoid cartilages are going to sit. And then we can't see this very well here, but let me just kind of, the epiglottic cartilage has a stem and a leaf, and it's going to articulate anteriorly with the thyroid cartilage, and it is going to form a good part of the laryngeal inlet here, along with the aryepiglottic folds and the craniculate cartilages that are atop the arytenoid cartilage. So here's the laryngeal inlet. That's for gas exchange between the larynx and the laryngopharynx. So let's take a little closer look at some of these elements. So here from the posterior, we can still see the craniculate cartilages that help to support these aryepiglottic folds. We have cuneiform cartilages embedded in those aryepiglottic folds to maintain a little bit of patency. We can see the posterior aspect of the thyroid cartilages there and where they articulate via their inferior horns with a cricoid cartilage. Over here is, I think, a really excellent view of things. So here is the thyroid cartilage. Here is the cricoid cartilage. And sitting atop the cricoid cartilage, we can see the arytenoid cartilages. The arytenoid cartilages are sort of the stars of the show with respect to sound production or phonation. From the larynx. These are very kinetic. They can glide, they can pivot, and it's probably important that you realize that there are two processes associated with the arytenoid cartilages. Anteriorly, there are vocal processes, and laterally, you can probably see this better here, laterally, there are muscular processes. So there's the muscular process, there's the vocal process. The vocal process actually attaches the vocal ligament to the arytenoid cartilage, and that goes out to the thyroid cartilage. It's my dog just shaking her head. And we can see those vocal ligaments there. When those vocal ligaments are invested by mucosa, they become vocal folds. You probably know them best as vocal cords. Those are the structures which are going to vibrate during phonation. And so, depending on what those arytenoid cartilages are doing, those vocal folds can either abduct so as to produce a maximally patent airway, or they can adduct, so that we can bring the folds into close association with one another for phonation. And that leads us to our assessment question, and that is, most intrinsic laryngeal muscles are able to affect phonation due to their attachment to which laryngeal cartilage? Is it A, arytenoid? Well, that sounds pretty good to me. B, cricoid? Well, we'll see how a lot of intrinsic laryngeal muscles also attach to the cricoid cartilage. That's a pretty good answer. Cuneiform? No. Epiglottic, no. Thyroid cartilage, some of them, but not too many. So really, we're limited to arytenoid and cricoid, and if this were a discussion of the intrinsic laryngeal muscles, we would probably have a more thorough background in which to make this decision, but suffice it to say, the arytenoid cartilages are the ones that are the most dynamic. They have the most intrinsic laryngeal muscles attached to them. So I would say A, arytenoid cartilage, best answer. Thank you very much for your time.